You know, when I came to Hollywood at 9, I remember working my very, very first movie. I was, what was it called? Best Foot Forward with Tommy Dix. Buckle down, win sake. Remember that? Anyway, you probably don't, but anyway. Sybil Jason, how are you?
Oh, I'm just great.
You remember that one, don't you, honey?
Oh, I sure do.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because you grew up in this business like I did when I was 9, but you were,
exactly.
What, 5 or 4?
Oh, well, actually, I was about a year and a half.
Were you really?
Yeah, really.
You are actually born in Cape Town.
Cape Town, South Africa.
It's a great place.
Well,
but
wonderful.
Your parents were English.
They were English.
English?
Right. Yes.
And you were in London? You went back to London?
Well, what had happened, that was a fluke. I left South Africa because my folks wanted to get me away from entertaining. They thought I was loving it too much.
Were they showbiz?
No, not at all.
Really? Okay.
So, actually, they sent us, me and my sister, over to England to get away from it. But it just boomed, and I got my start there in England.
Your first test was at the London studio, first film test.
That's right.
Tell me about that.
Well, actually, Gracie Fields, whose husband was a very big star in England at that time, they needed a little girl for one day's work. Mm-hmm. So I had never acted before, and my sister was a little reticent about it, but mm-hmm. Gracie Fields says, I think she can handle it.
Ah, but you came out there and did that Mae West. That Mae West was popular those days. You did Mae West at the Palladium?
The Palladium in Albert Hall.
Really? How old were you then at the play? 5?
Almost 5.
Almost 5.
Almost 5.
God, you did Mae West. I did too, darling.
Did
I used
you
to put
really?
My mother's high heels. and I went to see Mae West movies.
Oh.
And I just put my mother's high heels and got in.
Whoa.
That's it.
I'd like a nickel for everybody that's done Mae West.
Every boy and girl at our time. Remember
that's
you
great.
Wrote a great book. A book I love. I just finished it. My 15 Minutes.
That's right.
Look at you.
And they
Sybil.
Were wonderful 15 minutes. I'm one of those strange ex-child stars that love my career every single second of it.
You do?
Yeah.
You're looking at me and telling me the truth, darling. You really?
That's
honestly,
the truth.
You had
really?
A good time.
I loved it.
What made you come to Hollywood at the beginning? After leaving London, you went Warner Brothers, right away to Warner Brothers.
Right, exactly. Well, I was signed in London to be their first kid star. That's what brought me over to Hollywood.
Was Shirley Temple then at that time?
She was
a big star.
But I think she was doing baby burlesque still at that time.
Right.
And but then, you know, about a year later, she took over the whole industry.
Right, right, right. Your first film was with?
A Little Big Shot. It was with Edward Everett Horton.
Uh-huh.
And Bob Armstrong and Glenda Farrell.
Bob Armstrong. Isn't that the ape guy?
Hey, you got it.
Yeah.
Right.
I loved him. He did a movie with Terry Moore.
That's
about
right.
The ape and all that.
King Kong.
King Kong. That's
yes.
It. Yes. He was great, wasn't he?
Wonderful.
As a little girl doing these films, you worked with L. Jolson. I can't believe you worked with L. Jolson.
Right. And I adored him till the day he died. We were very, very close.
What do you mean by close? Like
talking
all the time? And
yeah, and I used to go to his home. He and Ruby at that time were still married.
Ruby Kelly, yeah.
Right.
Keller.
Ruby Keeler.
Yeah, Keeler, yeah. Keeler.
And then later on, I met his second wife. I think it was his fifth wife.
Uh-huh.
Very lovely lady with a wonderful sense of humor. Great gal.
Really? You did Jack, I want to get to Jack Warner because I know people really despise him, but he loved you.
Yes, and I
loved
him.
Tell me about Jack Warner.
Well, he was very, from the word go, he was easy to talk with. He didn't talk down to me. In fact, I don't remember anybody talking to me as if I were a child.
Really?
Really.
He talked just... Really?
Like we are talking
Jack Warner
right
never
now.
Talked down at you at all, like
never,
a little kid?
Never,
oh, you little
never,
darling
never.
Little girl. You didn't.
No.
That's
no.
Not great.
No.
What kind of schools did you go to there?
On the studio lot.
Uh-huh.
I had my own special tutor. And when I wasn't working, which was very that didn't happen very often. Then I had my...
You worked a lot, didn't you?
Oh, gosh, yes. If I wasn't working on a movie, which was rare, then they sent me on personal appearance tours around the country.
Yeah, and you did all those department stores, like May Companies, Bloomingdale's, and all
everything.
These...
Well, they showed Sybil Jason dresses and bathing suits and all that.
So you had a fashion thing going for you, too, didn't you?
Yeah, that's right.
How about the hair? The hair thing, too, going?
The hair
thing,
well, that was easy.
Look at this picture.
Michael Cortez. Yeah, that was my first director at Warner Brothers.
He was great.
My favorite director of all time.
Really? Why did he make you a favorite? Why? Why did you
Because he made things very, very clear.
Hey, and that's good.
He was a realist.
Uh-huh.
He was tough. He was very, very tough on the adults. I mean, I even felt that when I was a child. But look at the performances he got out of everybody.
Uh-huh. The
Fantastic.
Little Big Shot. That was your big movie, though. Big Shot.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Right.
Yeah, that was a great film.
Yeah, that was the song sheet from that.
Uh-huh. Michael did this, too. Michael Cortez.
Yes, Michael Cortez. Right.
And this is another one. Look at these pictures.
Yeah.
My God.
Right.
You did recordings for Decca.
For Decca
for
Records.
For children's recordings.
That's right. It was a Sybil Jason album of children's... Well, Victor Young was my orchestra.
Victor Young, that wonderful, a symphonic
Fantastic.
Orchestra?
Fantastic.
Really?
Yeah. And Victor was so funny, he looked like a prize fighter.
Uh-huh.
But what a musical soul. Uh-huh. He was fantastic.
You seem happy today.
I am happy.
Pat O'Brien, Sybil, look at you over Humphrey Bogart and the great O'Malley. Look at your title here, over Humphrey Bogart.
I often wonder what Bogie did to Jack Warner that got that billing.
That was a great one. Anne Sheridan was in that.
Oh, yes. Bless her heart.
I love Anne Sheridan.
Yes,
she was great Warner Brothers people.
Wonderful.
What is this changing of the guard?
That
Tell me about this.
That was a Technicolor short. That this is strange. There was a wonderful dance in there.
Uh-huh.
And Busby Berkeley, I worked with him. And the girls worked with Bobby Connolly.
Right.
And the first time we did the dance was... That was the first time we all got together.
Uh-huh.
Believe it or not, we didn't rehearse.
You didn't rehearse at all?
Not at all.
Why is that?
I don't know.
The camera just rolled on and that's it?
Well, you know, we got together when...
Right, right.
When we were going to shoot it.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, you brought a clip.
Yes.
I love to see this. This particular clip is the first one.
First one was from Little Big Shot.
Okay, that's your first.
Right.
Okay, let's see it. Okay?
Yeah, okay.
Let's do it.
Sure enough.
You're not holding in money.
Sure enough. Can you sing it?
Sure enough. You just pay it and leave the rest to me.
All right, boys. Rolling in money. Hit it!
Be a better spot over here.
Yeah? What makes you think so?
Well, a theater intermission. Always a lot of chumps in the crowd.
Why don't they leave me alone? I want to be alone. I work so hard. I'm so tired. I think I go home. Have I credit? Well, you said it. for a summer dream come true. And it's all to spend on a loving friend. What a break for a boy like you. I'm rolling in money. Rolling in money. If you're in there, do I make myself clear, boys? No, no words, cracks. Come up and sometime.
When you see yourself up there in that camera and film right now, what does Sybil think about? I mean,
you know,
that's years and years.
I tell you what really does go through my mind is not exactly the scene.
Right.
It was what preceded the scene or what we broke up and something was funny or whatever. That's what sticks out in my mind.
This is at Warner's, this particular
scene. This was at Warner's, right. Just about 95% of my career was Warner
at
Brothers.
At Warner Brothers.
Yeah.
My God, that's, you've had a good career, Sybil.
Oh, wonderful.
I mean...
And it was the golden era.
It was, wasn't it?
Golden era, truly.
Yeah, your parents must have been very, very proud of you.
They were very proud.
The money was scattered for children those days. The parents took the money. What happened to Sybil?
Well, some of it...
Put away?
Part of it was put away, but the Jackie Coogan Law has so many holes in it.
It didn't come in yet.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Oh, it was in.
Oh, it was in at the time?
Oh, yeah, but there were very large loopholes.
Tell me about Jackie Coogan. You knew him very well.
Yeah, quite well.
Yeah. What kind of guy was he?
Very, very nice.
Who's your favorite partner as an actor when you were a kid, at five or six? Who was Sybil?
Well, I loved Jolson, and I love...
You call him Jolly?
Yeah.
I love that.
I did.
That's cute.
And I loved Guy Kibbe.
Beautiful.
Wonderful. And May Robeson. Great.
Those are great.
And then, of course, my darling Kay Francis.
I loved
her. She portrayed my mother twice in two different movies, and she was the spitting image of my own mother.
Really?
Yeah.
Was she really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Right.
Jolson must have loved you. They're going to have a big thing for Jolson at April the 16th at the Beverly Garland in the Valley here.
Yes.
And it's going to be a Jolson tribute.
It
and
will
you
be
are
a
there, one of the big...
Well, you know, the Jolson Society for years...
It's called the Jolson Society.
Has flown me around the country to, guest star at their banquets. And it's a ball. I love it.
Your friend?
Yeah.
Shirley Temple, tell me about Shirley, because you and her... did two movies together.
Yeah. Little Princess and The Bluebird.
Right, The Bluebird I loved. You were a disabled little child there.
That's right.
You couldn't walk.
That's right.
And you were a darling.
Thank you very much.
Made everybody in the... You and Aunt Margaret O'Brien made everybody cry.
Yeah. Well, we often see Maggie. She's
you
a
do?
Great
yeah,
gal.
She is.
Oh, yeah. And Tear for Tear, we were pretty good.
Uh-huh. So I'm sitting here. You've had a good time. In your home? You're married now?
Yeah, 57 years worth.
57?
Yeah.
Oh, any kids?
Yep.
How many?
Tony, one girl.
Uh-huh.
And her middle name is for her two grandmothers, Mary for my mother and Anna for my husband's mother.
Sybil, tell me about the book, My 15 Minutes.
The book,
you wrote it yourself.
I wrote it.
It's an autobiography of a child star who was in the golden era of Hollywood.
That's right.
And it's so good. It really is.
I'm so glad.
You got so many pictures in this book.
109 of them.
Boy, I really...
Yes.
And you did it yourself.
Yes.
Took you a long time?
No, it really didn't. Once I got going, I wasn't quite sure if I had a book in me at the beginning.
Right.
But then one memory came, and then it came tumbling out.
That's what happens,
Yes.
Look at you and Jolson here. Let's show this picture.
That's my darling Jolson.
That's it. You, there you are.
Yeah.
What movie was this? That one?
Singing Kid.
Singing Kid.
The Singing Kid.
God, he was a great guy,
wasn't
he? One of my favorites.
Sure was.
And this lady you worked in 1938, Jane Wyman, and you worked with the president, Ronald Reagan.
I didn't work with him.
But he was in there.
This is funny. In this one short where Janie Wyman was the little ingenue.
Right.
There was a gentleman that kept on coming around and disrupting the set. We were on location.
Right.
The director didn't like it. and he kicked him off the set.
This is at Warner's, yeah.
That was Ronald Reagan.
Because Ronald Reagan was at Warner's.
Yeah, that's right.
He did a great movie.
Very, very nice man.
Was he?
Oh, very sweet.
Uh-huh.
Very, very
sweet. He did a great movie called one of my favorites.
Where he's the Gipper?
No, when he lost his legs.
King's Row. Fantastic.
With Anne Sheridan.
But, you know, I tell you, this is a good showcase for Ronald Reagan. He really was a deeper actor than he was given credit for.
That was a great one.
Wonderful.
Yeah, that was my favorite role of the Gipper.
Yeah, I think it was mine, too, for him.
Yeah. Did he say that was his favorite, too?
I don't know. But he's so famous for being the Gipper.
Uh-huh.
I think that kind of overrided King's Row, which is a shame.
Yeah. Let's go back now. Do you have any regrets? Because you and Shirley came together.
Yeah,
I mean, you two, similar. Both sang and danced. Come on, Sybil.
Right.
I mean, people confused. I'm looking at you sometimes, I say, oh my God, is that Shirley or what? Or Shirley, you know, Sybil?
Right.
Go ahead.
But see, she was this gorgeous little kid that all the mothers and fathers wanted to take home.
Right.
I was kind of like a weird, older than what I look.
I don't think so. We're going to show another clip and show you. You're not weird. Let's see. What clip are we seeing now?
I think it's Changing of the Guard.
Oh, Changing of the Guard. Oh,
right.
This one right here.
Yes.
You're going to dance.
Yes.
With the girls are
Busby Berkeley.
Okay,
yes.
That's it. Okay.
Changing of the guard. Should old acquaintance be
I love that. I think that's a great... Bootsie had some great girls. He really...
Wonderful. They were crackerjack.
Yeah. How many were there? At least 30, 40?
I think there were at least 30.
Really?
30, right.
You've worked with some great, great people.
Best, the icons of the industry.
You have. You have, really.
Yeah.
More so than Shirley.
You know,
really?
You know you're right.
I know so.
Yeah.
I looked it up. More so than Shirley Temple. Believe me,
you know, I was very, very fortunate, though, Skippy.
That's good. I like to hear that.
Very fortunate. Yeah.
That's good. I like people.
Never forgotten the generosity of Jack Warner.
Like what his...
I mean, he gave me the best. How can you do any better than your first director, Michael Curtiz?
Mm-hmm.
Dance director, Busby Berkeley. I mean, Mervyn LeRoy.
The best. Why do the people talk bad about Jack Warner so much? And you talking good about him. That is good. I like to hear that.
You know, I think it's because he was so corny. His dream was to have been a performer.
You just use the word corny? Is that what you said? I like that.
He
was corny.
He was corny.
Was he really?
He was really corny.
To be the chief?
But, you know, his heart was good.
Uh-huh.
He loved entertaining.
Ah, that's great.
Yeah.
That's great. Look at you. Elliot Ness?
Elliot Ness was my bodyguard.
1937.
Right.
This was in Cleveland?
That's right.
What were
Shaker
you doing
Heights.
In Cleveland, honey?
What I was doing was doing the first shovelful for the new Warner Brothers Theater.
In Cleveland?
That's right.
Really?
Yeah.
And it's still there?
Yeah. I don't know. Oh. I'm not sure.
Okay. Is this Judy Garland?
Judy.
Where?
Tommy Kelly and Benita Granville.
At a birthday party for
Freddie Bartholomew.
Oh,
right.
My God, Benita Granville.
Yeah. See, in the back of Benita
Granville. Dickie Moore.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, you got
Dickie
a good eye.
Dickie Moore.
Yeah.
I just saw him with Jane Powell
right.
last week.
Right.
Yeah.
He wrote a book, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. We're all in it.
I didn't see that book. Is it out now?
Yeah, it's an older book.
It's an older book?
Yeah.
Tell me about the day at the Santa Anita. I'm a gambler. I love to go to the races.
Oh, do you really?
I'm a gambler, love races. And this is the day.
Well, look at all my guest stars. Edward G. Robinson, Olivia de Havilland, Jolie and Ruby Keeler, Betty Davis.
Betty Davis?
Yes.
They were all yours. And look at you. You got top billing.
Yeah.
My God. And they still show those things.
Because
you were
it.
Interviewed by Robert Osborne.
Yes, what a doll he is.
And
he's gorgeous.
Who's this? Shirley Temple?
Yeah, that's Shirley and myself.
Growing up. You're two ladies growing up. Look at you two lovely ladies.
Right. We work well together.
Yeah.
And we're very good friends to this day.
Still. What is she doing right now?
She's still on her second book. It's taking her a long time.
Uh-huh.
It's not about her career. It's about her political career.
Yeah, she's very political, isn't she?
Wonderful.
She helps people a lot.
Right. Oh, yeah.
She's not Democrat or Republican.
But she's Republican.
Is she Republican?
All the way.
Is she really?
Yes.
Well,
yes.
I'll forgive her.
Okay.
This is my and this is Roddy McDowell.
Oh,
very
my
good friend
God.
Of mine. I
you
love
know,
Roddy.
Everybody loved Roddy.
I met him years and years ago, and then I met him again. This is I met him again. Where was this? At the Jeanette McDonald's club?
That's right. It was the banquet, right.
The banquet for everybody to love Roddy.
Yeah. What a precious man he was.
He died so...
Too young.
Yeah, Elizabeth Taylor, she just devastated over his death.
Of course she was.
Just devastated.
Because they were kid stars together.
Yeah.
And off the set, they were very, very close, as you well know.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
You brought another clip. This is the clip you brought.
Yes.
Tell me about this.
That's Little Princess, right.
With Shirley Temple?
That's right.
Look at you and Shirley. Okay, let's see the clip, okay?
Okay.
Let's see it.
Oh, man. Oh. Here's my Christmas, but I'm so very good. Oh, thank you, Becky. But I'm nothing but friendliness. And the flannel aren't so very new. Why, you dear Becky, you made it all yourself. Yes, miss. I made it at night. I knew you could pretend it was setting with diamond pins stuck in. It's beautiful, Becky. I shall love it. Oh, really, miss? The flannel aren't so very new.
And this isn't so very new either.
is my present to you.
A present for me, Miss?
Yes, Becky, with my love.
Oh, what is it, Miss?
It's a scarab from Egypt. My daddy gave it to me because it brings good luck. I'd rather you had it than anyone else I know.
Oh, Lomas. I think I'm going to find
it. Oh, no, Becky. Not now. I have lots more presents for you, too, in my room.
I don't know what to say, Miss.
You're sweet, Becky.
Sybil, what have you learned about yourself and life?
You know, as long as I can remember, I've enjoyed people. Mm-hmm. I love people to this day. It's a joy every day to meet new ones.
Right, right.
Yeah, and I'm very enthusiastic about life. It doesn't matter how old you are,
right.
But the enthusiasm has to be there.
What's the most single, gratifying moment in your life, really?
When I had my daughter.
Oh. Really? Yes. How many kids you have?
One.
Just one.
And she's gorgeous. We couldn't top her. She's uh-huh. beautiful.
And is she and in the business?
No. She could have been 10 times over, but she's a teacher and she loves
oh,
it.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. That's nice. When yeah. she sees your movies, what does she think about?
She's very proud.
Is she?
Yes.
Yeah, that's...
When she was younger, it was a little awkward for her.
Yeah.
Now she's proud.
Like Shelley Winters' daughter.
Right.
Victoria. She doesn't like to see her mother in films. She's a doctor, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she's very strict in that.
Right.
If you had to do it all over again, I bet you said it, you would do it all over exactly.
Exactly.
Same way?
Exactly.
Because you're expressing that in this book.
That's right. I was hoping that whoever read it would feel like they were in a room with me and we were just talking.
Yeah.
And the people that have read it have been emailing me, and it's just wonderful. They say, cannot put it down.
Two stars, child stars, when they come up, well, actually three. I'm not gonna leave Margaret O'Brien
oh,
out.
Oh, no, not at
but
all.
Sybil Jason, you are one of the three great children stars.
Thank you very much.
Temple, Jason, and Margaret O'Brien,
yeah.
And the male star is actually Roddy McDowall.
Oh, yeah,
this
definitely.
This is, Hollywood must have been good in those days, because I enjoyed it when I was a kid here.
Oh, my goodness.
It's so different today.
Oh, dear.
How do you feel about walking down Hollywood Boulevard today when you see it? Come on, be honest with
me. Oh,
sad.
I'm in tears.
You are.
Right. And what really strikes me badly is when these tourists come and...
And they think that is Hollywood, and it's not,
no,
is it?
It's not at all.
See?
I'm pretty happy about what they did at Hollywood and Highland.
Yes, for that one little block.
That's right, one little block.
Yeah, absolutely.
But at least that's something, Skip.
Yeah.
It's better than nothing.
I don't know about the mayor of the Hollywood. They should do a little more. And Mr. Grant tried, but that's okay.
Right.
You have your star in Hollywood Boulevard.
No, I don't.
No, we're going to get you one.
No,
you don't? You know what the trouble is? I hate this. They make stars pay for their own star on Hollywood Boulevard.
It's like $17,000 now.
Awful, awful,
yeah.
Just awful. I think
right.
It's disgusting.
You know, Jack Warner wanted a star for me.
Right.
And before they could really do it, he put in the request.
Right.
And Jack died.